This episode is supported by Prudential. In this video, I want to talk about a serious disorder that affects billions of people worldwide. And while many treatments are available, some of them better than others, they simply result in remission from the condition at best, with reoccurrences happening early and often after treatment. It's called stuck song syndrome. I've had the song that doesn't end in my head for 3 days. You know the one.
This is the song that doesn't end. Yes, it goes on and on, my friend.
Think of the last time you got a song stuck in your head. What was it? And how long did it take you to get it out? There are a lot of different names for this. Sticky music, brainworms, and most commonly, earworms, which was originally coined by German scientists who called them Ohrwürmer. And it seems like everyone has a different method of getting rid of them. Luckily, there are brave researchers working to understand and treat this horribly annoying condition. Neuroscientists call earworms involuntary musical imagery, as opposed to voluntary musical imagery, where you sing a song in your head by choice. One study showed that over 90% of people suffer from earworms at least once a week, with about a third of people dealing with it every day. Most of the time, earworms consist of just fragments of familiar songs that repeat over and over, rather than being a complete song. And that helps us understand what causes brainworms and how to treat them. Psychologists call it the Zeigarnik effect, where people remember a task that was interrupted or not completed better than they remember a completed task. It was first noted in waiters who could remember the details of outstanding orders, but not paid closed orders. For earworms, this could mean you're more likely to get a song stuck in your head if you hear some of it, but not all of it. And since we hear music in a bunch of different settings, like the radio, TV show and commercials, and grocery store background noise, there's really no way to actively avoid getting an earworm. Sorry. But luckily the Zeigarnik effect also gives us an idea of how to get a stuck song out of your head. Complete it. A lot of people do this intuitively. When a song is stuck in your head, no matter how much you dislike it, you put the song on and listen to it from beginning to end. Research shows us there may be an easier way. If you can voluntarily play the end of the song in your head, you might be able to finally get it out of your brain. The Zeigarnik effect also tells us why some songs are so much stickier than others. Tunes like The Song That Gets On Everybody's Nerves or the chorus of Rihanna's Umbrella are usually sung as a repeating round, so they get easily stuck. But the most famous of these songs is, of course, It's a Small World. The tune played on a ride of the same name at several Disney theme parks. It's an uplifting song about world unity, but its repetitive nature makes it extremely mentally invasive, uniting the world in their deep hatred of the tune. How do you get a song out of your head if it doesn't have an ending to sing? If only I knew. My best advice is try replacing it with the song that does end by voluntarily playing the new song in your head over and over again. Once the second song is thoroughly stuck, play the end of it to get it out. And whatever you do, don't think about the song that doesn't end. Too late. Thanks to Prudential for sponsoring this episode. It's human nature to prioritize present needs and what matters most to us today. But when planning for your retirement, it's better to prioritize tomorrow. According to a Prudential study, 1 in 3 Americans is not saving enough for retirement, and over 52% are not on track to be able to maintain their current standard of living. Go to prudential.com/save more and see if you start saving more today, you can continue to enjoy the things you love tomorrow.